Hi, I'm CHASA Commissioner Rhonda Blanford Green. High school students learn so much through their participation in athletics and activities, but in order for them to learn what we need them to, they have to be safe. CHASA has developed a series of videos to help schools, coaches, students, and parents focus on safety and participation. This video addresses heat.
Heat illness is the second leading cause of sudden death in athletes, behind cardiac disease. However, heat illness is 100% preventable. Heat illness should never happen, period. With knowledge and proper planning, we can prevent both minor and life-threatening versions of heat illness.
What is critical is that parents provide a complete and accurate medical history prior to sports participation. This information saves lives.
So the importance of doing a pre-participation sports physical before the beginning of any sports season is so that the physician has a good opportunity to obtain all the cardiovascular history and look for any family history of sickle cell trait or disease, asthma, diabetes, or any allergies that the child might have.
Heat illnesses and injuries related to heat can be a challenge because of Colorado's climate. Colorado's high altitude, low humidity, and intense sunlight can put athletes at risk for environmental illness. Any predisposition to asthma, allergies, medications, and the like creates the need for care.
Environmental conditions, heat, humidity, fitness level, physical exertion, clothing and equipment can impact the potential for heat illness.
Appropriate water breaks, providing shade, and modifying practice are also critical when environmental conditions dictate.
Types of heat illness include cramps, heat exhaustion, and heat stroke. Heat cramps are painful involuntary muscle spasms and are generally innocent and easily treatable. Heat exhaustion is a concerning type of heat illness where body temperature is rising and the athlete experiences dizziness, weakness, and headache. Heat stroke is the most extreme heat illness and is life-threatening. The body and mental status decline in dangerous fashion, and the athlete may collapse suddenly. This is a medical emergency.
With a heat illness, time matters. Have a high index of suspicion. A severe heat illness is not something that you want to miss, and you always want to err on the side of caution.
Any athlete that is suffering from heat illness will display dizziness, weakness, fatigue, nausea, and profuse sweating and headache.
The effects and problems that can follow are directly related to the amount of time that the body temperature is elevated. Treat them right away. The first step is to initiate the emergency action plan.
Every school should have a fully developed and executed emergency action plan that addresses essential personnel, essential training, and the essential equipment that is available during an emergency.
If the situation is severe, call 911, then initiate proper medical protocol, including the ABCs, airway, breathing, circulation, and exposure. Exposure means get them cooled down immediately. Get them into a protected environment, which is cool or a shaded area. Rapid cooling must begin immediately. If an ice bath is available, submerge them immediately. If not available, utilize a hose to drop the body temperature or place ice in the armpit and groin. At the very least, rotate cold towels on and off the body every 2 minutes. Get to know the patient. Ensure that blood sugar, sickle cell trait, heart issues, or other problems are not contributing to what you are seeing with the athlete. Doctors, trainers, staff, and parents need to recognize that severe heat illness can have late complications, and the athlete needs to be carefully monitored. In every case, err on the side of further evaluation by an emergency department or a physician.
It is extremely important to have collaboration among school personnel, medical personnel, and families. This type of collaboration and communication creates safe, healthy, competitive, and enjoyable athletic experiences.
Taking a leadership role in sports and activities, and as an extension of player safety, risk minimization, and sports medicine, CHASA has long been a leader in educating its membership, coaches, parents, and players in the best practices to make participation experience better and safer. In a collaboration of mixture of CHASA bylaws and state statute, students are better protected today than ever before. The CHASA bylaws require physical exams, and parental consent prior to participation, and have established protocols for students who are removed from play for injury. Also, each school is required to have an emergency action plan for each facility it uses for athletic competition. State statutes, crafted and supported by CHASA personnel, address mandatory training in the use of AEDs and CPR. Concussion education and other important pieces are critical to students' participation in athletics and activities. Unfortunately, injuries are part of the participation experience, but the focus on practices that minimize those potential injuries is the singular focus of the CHASA Sports Medicine Committee. With the proactive approach of the CHASA Sports Medicine Committee, students continue to find their participation a better and safer experience.
As coaches, we deal with so many different personalities and responsibilities that it's important for us to know the best resources.
Whenever I need sports medicine and player safety information, I go to ChASANow.com and click on the sports medicine page. It has everything I need to help my players stay safe.